Hi guys, welcome back to another video about IELTS speaking part 2. And in today's video, I'm gonna talk about this topic. Describe an occasion when many people were smiling, okay? And for this topic, I'm gonna talk about my sister's wedding party. And here it goes. I'm gonna talk about my sister's wedding party, which was a time when everyone was all smiles. If I'm not mistaken, it took place almost 4 years ago. At the time, my sister had been dating her boyfriend for more than 3 years. And after they got their parents' blessing, they decided to tie the knot. It was a big day for my sister, so she was quite nervous because lots of people were gonna be there. Fortunately, everything went well and the wedding was a blast. It lasted about 2 hours with loads of fun. It was hosted at a beautiful wedding and the venue looked quite romantic and elegant with great decor and lighting. Most of the guests were my parents' friends and some were my sister's friends. They all dressed up beautifully to celebrate one of the happiest days of my sister's life. Everyone walked in the building with a bright smile on their face. At the beginning of the party, we sat around round tables and swapped life stories. Then we enjoyed yummy sit-down meals from the restaurant and proposed a toast to the bride and groom. While we were at it, some guests came on the stage and performed love songs to wish the couple lifelong happiness. There were lots of singing and dancing, and the place was filled with laughter. The atmosphere at that time was so warm and cozy. At the end of the party, people took turns to take a photo with the newlywed couple and send their wishes to them before leaving. I could say that everyone was all happy that day, especially my sister. I could sense that she was thrilled to bits. Hopefully, my future wedding will be as fascinating as hers, okay? And that's my model answer for part 2. And now, let's move to part 3. Two-way discussion. Question 1. Do you think people who like to smile are friendlier? Yeah, I suppose so. This is particularly true when I go to a new place and meet new people. I find it a lot easier to strike up a conversation with someone who smiles at me than a person who looks cold or keeps a straight face when I look at them. Apparently, smiling isn't the only factor in deciding a person's level of friendliness, but it's among the biggest ones. Alright? Question 2. Why do most people smile in photographs? Well, that's an intriguing question. I gotta admit, I've never wondered that because I always assumed it was a natural thing to do when being photographed. Now that you asked me, I guess one of the main reasons for that is we all want to look good when getting our photos taken, and one of the easiest way to do that is to smile. Also, taking photos is a great way to keep memories when we do something, and nobody wants to look unhappy in such photos. So they have a tendency to crack a smile when standing in front of the camera. Alright, question 3. Do women smile more than men? I think gender has nothing to do with this. It's more of a personality thing. If a person has a cheerful and exuberant personality, they'll have a tendency to smile more than those who don't. Take my best friend as an example. He always wears a smile on his face whenever he's with other people, while it's the other way around for me. I rarely smile and I usually find it awkward to do so, even though I know it'll make me appear kind of unfriendly and sometimes cocky. And the last question for this part. Do people smile more when they are younger or older? Okay, I would say the latter, because to me, when people grow older, they seem to have fewer things to worry about compared to when they are younger. I mean, at that stage, They may have had almost everything figured out in their lives. So things like how to make ends meet and provide for their family or how to deal with all the workplace drama would no longer be a big problem to them. That's why they might enjoy their lives more and smile more often. All right, and that's all of my model answers for this topic. Hopefully they have been helpful for you guys. And if you have any trouble dealing with one certain kind of topic in IELTS speaking part 1 or part 2, please let me know by leaving a comment at the comment section, okay? And once again, my name is Jimmy, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next videos. Bye-bye.